in. I think one of the features that will have struck everybody today is that we've been very much a symposium on the move between the various venues and all the rest of it. So this is, and we've had a very rich discussion of all the different topics concerning integral ecology. This is a time where we don't move, and this is a time where we don't have to speak, we just have to listen and absorb. It's a reflective time. And as I said yesterday, one of the great ways in which we can celebrate what it is to be human and also bring the whole of creation into that is through our art. And that's partly what we want to do this afternoon. Everything you need, all the reflections, everything, the whole program is here. So that's all that you need.
Thank you. Laudato si, mi signor. Praise be to you, my Lord. In the words of this beautiful canticle, St. Francis of Assisi reminds us that our common home is like a sister with whom we share our life, and a beautiful mother who opens her arms to embrace us. Praise be to you, my Lord, through our sister and mother Earth, who sustains and governs us, and who produces various fruit with colored flowers and herbs. This sister now cries out to us because of the harm we have inflicted on her by our irresponsible use and abuse of the goods with which God has endowed her. We have come to see ourselves as her lords and masters, entitled to plunder her at will. The violence present in our hearts, wounded by sin, is also reflected in the symptoms of sickness evident in the soil, in the water, in the air, and in all forms of life. This is why the earth herself, burdened and laid waste, is amongst the most abandoned and maltreated of our poor. She groans in travail. We have forgotten that we ourselves are dust of the earth. Our very bodies are made up of her elements. We breathe her air, and we receive life and refreshment from her waters. The ecological conversion needed to bring about lasting change is also a community conversion. This conversion calls for a number of attitudes which together foster a generous spirit of care, full of tenderness. First, it entails gratitude and gratuitousness, a recognition that the world is God's loving gift, and that we are called quietly to imitate his generosity in self-sacrifice and good works. Do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. It also entails a loving awareness that we are not disconnected from the rest of creatures, but joined in a splendid universal communion. As believers, we do not look at the world from without, but from within. Conscious of the bonds with which the Father has linked us to all beings, by developing our individual God-given capacities, an ecological conversion can inspire us to greater creativity and enthusiasm in resolving the world's problems and in offering ourselves to God as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. We do not understand our superiority as a reason for personal glory or irresponsible dominion, but rather as a different capacity which in its turn entails a serious responsibility stemming from our faith.
Thank you. Book Surrender by Daryl Conley. The world is charged with the grandeur of God. It will flame out like shining from ship oil. It gathers to a greatness like the ooze of oil crushed. Why do men then now not break this rod? Generations have trod, and all is seared with trade, bleared, smeared with foil, and wears man's smudge, and shares man's smell. The soil is bare now. No man could feel any trouble. And for all this, nature is never spent. There lives the dearest freshness deep down things. And though the last lights of the black west went, oh, morning, the brown room eastward springs. Because the Holy Ghost over the bent dark rooms with warm breath and with bright wings.
Thank you.
The wind tore up by your burning wings. To Christ, O Lord. I caught this morning, morning's meaning. Kingdom of daylight dawn, dappled dawn drawn from him, in his riding of the golden level underneath him, steady there, and striding high there, how he rung upon the rain of a whooping wing in his ecstasy. Then off on the swing, as a state's heel sweeps smooth on a bow bend, the herd gliding above by the big wind. My heart, in hiding, stirred for a bird, the achievement of the mastery of the thing. Brute through beauty and valor and act. Oh, air, pride, plume, ear, buckle. And the fire that breaks from me then, a brilliant, times told, lovelier. More dangerous, oh my shining. No wonder of it. Sheer blood makes cloud down and simian shine. And blue weak embers, oh my dear fool, all themselves and gash old within.
When despair for the world grows in me, and I wake in the night at the least sound, in fear of what my life or my children's lives may be, I go in my hand with a wood drake best as he leads me to the water, and the great heron feeds. I come in for the peace of wild things, who do not tax their lives with forethought. Waiting with the light. For a time, I rest in the grace of